welcome back, everyone. I'm Matsuya Rupik, and today we are here to play a game of Yandere Simulator. So, for those of you who have not seen this game before, I am going to put an age warning in here, as well as a trigger warning. This game is not for children. I do feel the need to give that warning because there are a lot of younger people watching my videos. But if you are under 13, I would not recommend watching this at all. If you are under 18, I'd say get an adult to watch this video first and see if it's okay for you to watch, because this is an adult game. As well as a trigger warning as well, there is, as you can see through the opening there, there is killing involved in this game. There's some other stuff involved in this game. We're just going to be killing today, but if you're thinking about checking out Yandere Simulator for yourself and you do have issues with some of the stuff, this game does involve bullying, harassment, stalking, several other adult things. So if you're not comfortable with that, that's perfectly fine. You probably didn't subscribe to me for that sort of stuff, but this is a game that I've been playing a lot recently, and I've really been enjoying it. It's not usually my type of game, but I don't know, I guess I'm just interested in the story. Those are always the kind of things that I'm normally interested in. So we are going to go ahead and get this game started. Today we're going to actually be doing a challenge. We are going to be trying to get away with murder. And not just any kind of murder. I'm actually gonna need new panties for this. We are going to try to get away with mass murder, mass genocide. So, get new panties on. These panties are going to increase our speed and make us run a lot faster. Now, the way this challenge works is I have to kill everybody in the school without any Easter eggs or debugs. I will be doing one thing in this game that's a little cheatish, but that's just to get to make the challenge go faster. Because this is a very long challenge. As you can see, this is our school. There's our gym teacher over here. I'm gonna go ahead and change our shoes like a good little Yandere girl. And we are going to do a couple of things. Now, these I'm not I don't feel are too much like cheating, because in the actual game we will actually have time to do all of these things regularly, but just for making this go a little bit faster, go ahead and increase our stats here. I'll go ahead and increase them all. Oops. Ah. Come on. My, controller has been bugging out a lot lately, so you will notice a lot of stuff happening in this. So we're going to raise our physical education up, and we're going to join the martial arts club and get rid of this eye patch here. So we are going to head up to the martial arts club, which should be around here somewhere. I believe it's by the stairs on this end. Yep. And we are going to come in here. We're going to wait for Budo. And then we are going to reset the day. But we're not going to reset the day like normal. We're actually going to change the day back to Monday so that we could keep all of our fixes that we've done. We'll keep our underwear. We'll keep our club that we're in, we'll keep our stats, because otherwise this takes a lot, and I don't feel like fighting the teachers or the martial artists in this. Another thing that we're going to try to do is we're going to try to keep anybody from seeing us. Now, if we are killing that person, then it's okay for them to see us, but we do not want to be seen by anyone that we can't kill, like Senpai, or anyone that we're not in a good position to kill. Like, if a, like, say we're in a room full of people over here, and all these people do see us, they're, if, as long as we can kill all these people in one go, then that's okay. We just can't have any witnesses, and we especially can't have Senpai notice us. So we're gonna go talk to Budo here and join the martial arts club.
You are now an official member of the...
Yeah, we don't care. And so, yeah, this is pretty much it. So now it's time to reset the day and get this challenge started. Alright, so we got the game going. We're going to grab these scissors, because this way people can actually, like, we can talk to people, with the scissors in our hands. And we got to, where am I going? So, in order to make this work, we're going to come up here to the Light Music Club and talk to this little turtle here. And we're going to enable sanity animations. By enabling sanity animations, we make it so that we can do sneak attacks on people. So we can kill a lot of people without anybody noticing, because there won't be any screams. So I'm gonna come out here. I'm gonna wait for all of these kitties to go inside. And you know what, while we're doing that, let's go ahead and kill the gym teacher. So this is why we joined the martial arts club, because we want to be able to kill the teachers as well. And you can fight them, however, I really don't want to. So we're going to get our scissors back out. And while they are... Ah! Fuck! Okay, so unfortunately when we tried to kill Musume, everybody saw us, and that was no good. She screamed though, she shouldn't have screamed. We were sneak attacking her, and she really should not have screamed like that. So we're going to come back up here, enable sanity animations again. Hey, Mr. Turtle, you're supposed to allow me to use sanity animations, which means allowing sneak attacks. I need to be able to sneak attack if I'm going to complete this challenge. So we're gonna come back out here. Okay, so once again, we gotta wait for all the students to go inside. And there, once they're across that threshold, they won't be able to see this. And now we just got to go hide to this body over here. And the reason I wanted to increase my strength is because it makes it so that I can run faster. Because otherwise we would be really slow right now. Okay, so there we go. That's what's supposed to happen. All right, and now sneak attack. Do this again. What are you martial artists running away for? You're supposed to fight me. Now the really frustrating thing about this is that I've actually done this already. I've been able to prove that this is possible, and I just really wanted to make a video on this, but I keep screwing it up. So let's try this one more time. Get the scissors back out. There There we go. And I think my problem was that I attacked her around the corner. So there we go. Let's get these two before they go upstairs. Okka. Enough of my waifu. And she saw me, but that's okay. Hopefully she doesn't glitch out through the floor. Oh, fuck. Hopefully nobody sees her. Okay, I'm gonna pick Okka up real quick because I don't want her to glitch through the stairs. And I'm gonna get our scissors back out, and we're gonna finish these suckers off. But bam! Die! And she's about to go up the stairs. And there. And pick her up so she doesn't glitch out through the stairs. And now we just got to hide all of these bodies. So, I'm gonna go pick up Musume because we don't want Kokona to see her when she goes to take the compensated dating call. And this is our top priority over here because we do not want anyone to see any of these bodies that are over here. Unfortunately, this means that we won't be able to go to class even if we clean everything up because my waifu decided to go off the map, and even though she is off the map and we cannot reach her, teachers still can find her. But that's okay because we got a lot of work to do, and it is going to take more time than we have to get it done. So go ahead and hide these over here. And I could hide them in a closer classroom, but come on, Budo. Get your butt up here, Budo. I could hide them in a closer classroom, but we will have to run all these guys over to the incinerator, which is a very long chore. And just tossing them in here should do the trick. So in the official game, when it comes out, we will have to clean up all this blood because people will be able to notice the blood. But for right now, the people are not programmed to notice any of this blood up here. So we are not going to get the turtle to forgive our sins because that glitches out a lot. We will go ahead and laugh off this insanity over here while we're waiting for Kokona. Because we do have to wait for Kokona to take her call because that is the best way to kill her. So let's just wait over here. Can't really let her see us, but once she takes her call, we will be good. Alright, so Kokona is out here. She's sitting here taking her call. For those of you who've never seen this game, I'll just go ahead and let her talk.
I told you not to call me when I'm at school.
Oh, she is loud.
Like I said, that was a one-time thing. I don't want to do that again.
Hey, Kokona, do me a favor and don't turn around, please.
How much did you say?
Uh-huh, yep, just enough for you, that's for sure.
Well, if it's just one more time, then I guess it's okay.
Girl, you be dirty!
How about tonight?
Yep. Oh, they re-recorded that. She said Shisuta before. Now it's Shisuta. Okay.
I can't believe I'm doing this.
Don't worry, you won't. Alright, now we just got to pick her up and go hide her body. And the rest of this will be a lot easier once it's class time. So going to go ahead and clean ourselves up, make sure that there is nothing over here. Good. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and clean ourselves up and wait for class time. Oh, I almost forgot. There are some students up top here that we can kill that nobody will notice. And they should be right over here. And there's some students on the roof as well. You gotta wait for them to go to class, but you can kill them While they are heading to class, Pippi, turn your music off. Ryota, quit ignoring Pippi. Now, these guys have glitched through the walls before, so going to pick them up. So you can see, Pippi over here is trying to get away from the wall. And if they get into that wall there, I will never be able to pick them up. So, I'm going to go ahead and close this door. And I'm insane again, but that's okay. Going to come up here to the roof. And Kudere is over here. Nobody will notice her. And die, die, die. Ah, I couldn't. Oh, hey, no, no. You get your butt over here. And we are going to hide her body over here, right next to where the gym teacher's at. Well, not right next to her, but you get the idea. So now we just gotta wait for those girls to go to class, and then we can kill them. We already got Oka. So now that we are sane again, we're still bloody, but that's okay. Get our scissors back out, and we just gotta wait for 8 o'clock so that these girls can go to class. Okay, so it is finally 8 o'clock. So we got to go. We gotta wait for them to be away from Midori, because otherwise Midori will see them, and we don't want to risk her calling the cops. And even though we could fight these two, I just want to sneak attack! And sneak attack you! And now we sneak attack you. Or we could just murder your ass. And now that that is done, it's going to be really difficult to get down to the washroom, because everybody's going to be in the hallways. And we're going to go ahead and pick up Yusaku or Yuinkyu. Whatever, we're going to pick up this Basu sister. I think that's Saki Basu. Going to pick up her. And we are going to come down here and we're going to watch, okay? So those guys are in their classrooms. But we still got to wait for the teachers to enter their classrooms, and this is actually the hard part. I mean, it's easy, but it's also hard, especially in Senpai's classroom. That's where I always seem to get messed up, because of Misume, like, I'll laugh and try to get the teachers out, and then Misume will sometimes hear instead and try to investigate. And really, all the classrooms on the left-hand side are pretty difficult, because sometimes the way that the animation is done, they get tossed over to the right-hand side, and sometimes they clip into the classroom, and then everybody sees them, and it is a pain in the ass. But let's hope that that doesn't happen to us today. So, make sure there's no teachers coming from stairs over here. Okay, good. I think the teacher is in the classroom now. Yes. Okay. And there's Senpai. Oh wait, no, this is, yeah, that is Senpai. Senpai! Senpai, we love you. Love you, Senpai. So this is how you get the teacher to come out here. Hopefully she saw that. I don't like checking to see if they saw it or not, because it's, oh, yep, there she goes. Okay. So we're just gonna come over here, get our scissors ready, and I try to go over to this side over here so that, no, don't. Oh, thank goodness, she wasn't far enough into the wall to be seen. And we gotta really hide this bitch, because for some reason the game is glitching out and it wants to show, they can see through walls. It's really annoying. So we are going to come over here. We're going to giggle and get this guy out here. And there we go. Now he's dead. Close this door so Senpai don't see. Okay. So there's the hard part. Now we're gonna go hide him over here, because we don't want anyone to see, just in case we can't finish this before lunchtime. But I should be okay. Okay, so Senpai's class is done. Now we just got to wash, rinse, and repeat with these other teachers. Make sure she's heard that. Okay, good, she heard. Get that out. And this is, like, you gotta wait for her to be turned around this way. Best not to attack her when she is looking this way. So go ahead and hide her body in here. Oh, and she's stuck in the wall. Grab her before... Ah, great. Come on. There, and her legs got messed up. That's okay. So, this next part is actually very easy, because all I gotta do is sneak attack from behind. Because they don't even see this. They don't hear this. They don't see this. And there we go. So go ahead and close the door. And now we just come on down here. Get this teacher. Did she see that? Yes, she did. Or not, she didn't see it. She heard it. Okay. Come on. Come on. There you go. And run, 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 run! Getcha! Now we just go hide her. Like we did the other teachers. And get scissors back out. Fortunately, the button for going to class is different from the attack button, because I actually messed that up the last time that I did this. Like, I got everybody killed, I got them in the incinerator, and then all of a sudden I accidentally went to class while I was mopping up the blood, and yeah, that was not fun. Fortunately, I had already disposed of my own evidence, so I still technically got away with it. But I want to get away with this the proper way. And, oh, I forgot to, Oh, shoot. Fuck! Fuck. Nope. Okay, good. You saw nothing! How dare you! How dare you! I was doing so well! Was doing so well! And then you fucking saw! Die! Now you guys get to sleep with your teacher. I was gonna leave the teacher in the bathroom, but now you guys get to have fun with your teacher in here. Okay. Now we just got one more floor to do. And going to laugh out here. Come on, there she goes. Oh my gosh, we are so insane right now. And bye-bye. Okay, there we go. This time I got her from over here. And I saw her trying to get into that classroom too. She was trying so hard. And where am I going? Here we go. Okay. And this way. She was really trying to inch her way out of that room, or back into this room, but we can't let her do that because we got to kill these students in here and we do not want them to be alerted. So, there we go. And I got this challenge from another YouTuber, the Cub Scouts. He makes Yandere videos a lot as well. I've been watching him a lot lately, and in the challenge it said that you can't let anyone see you, but I'm like, you know what, as long as they die right away, I don't really see any harm in letting anyone see you. But it's still best to try to keep them from seeing you, because they might be able to get away, they might call the police, they might go tell a teacher. But now we just got 3 more students to kill, 2 more, and 1 more! Ba-bam! That is everybody. Go ahead and check the student info. No, not stats, come on. My controller is so glitchy. So we got Senpai, we got Info-chan, we can't kill them. Not without Easter eggs, and yep, that's it. These two do not actually exist, but we got all the teachers, we got all the students except for Senpai and Info-chan. So we are good, and now we just gotta go hide all of these bodies, and let's see here. So yeah, the incinerator is open now. Normally there are a bunch of delinquents over here, and we really don't want to deal with them, which is why it's okay that we're skipping class, because they will not be over here as long as class is in session. Thank goodness, because we have a lot, and I mean a lot, of bodies to get rid of. If you thought killing everybody was time consuming, you were dead wrong, because this is the hard part right here. It is disposing of every single body and cleaning up all of the blood. It is a chore. That's also why I wanted to pick people up instead of dragging them, because then they just create more blood, and that's no good. We gotta clean all that up. And that is no good at all. And this is why I wanted to increase my strength, because now that we have to run around a lot, that extra speed is going to help us quite a bit. And as much as I would love to go join the track team to increase my speed, I cannot, because I am still in the martial arts club, and I cannot leave the martial arts club because Budo is dead. That's a lot of fun. So now we just gotta go pick up Red here. And this part is very time consuming, so we'll just go ahead and speed through all of this so that you guys don't have to sit here through all of it. Okay, so now that we've gotten rid of everybody on the first floor, now comes the fun part. So this can go either one of two ways. You can either run all the way downstairs with all these bodies, or what I like to do is I like to just bring them up here and dump them off the roof up here. It's a little bit faster, because then I can just run back and forth. And we'll go ahead and get these girls while we're up here. And then one thing I've noticed is that after a certain amount of time, you stop making footprints. Like, I have walked through so many puddles of blood, and check that out. See, I'm not even making footprints anymore. And I don't know if that's a glitch, or maybe it's intentional. Maybe the game can't handle making that many bloody footprints. I don't know, but it certainly works in my favor, because it means that I'm not going to be making any more blood to be needing to clean up. Make sure I got everyone in here. Yes. Okay, so that should be everyone on this floor. Just double check this classroom again. Okay. So now I just gotta clean up this floor down here. And so now this is where I got messed up. Well, I mean, this isn't exactly where I got messed up, but like, this is the place where I got messed up before, because those of you who've played Yandere Sim before already know that that little pink circle there, that is going to class. And if you try to go to class while there's evidence around, yeah, you're pretty much fucked. And wrong floor. So now this second floor here, this is definitely the most fun, and I use the term fun loosely. Because A, this is where your classroom is at, and B, it's pretty awkward having to go up all these stairs. Up and down, up and down, up and down, up and down. And it certainly takes a while to clear up everything, but we are almost done. Thank goodness. Is that everyone in here? Yes, okay. Alright, and now... Oh, fuck. Wrong floor! Senpai! Oh, thank goodness Senpai didn't notice me. That would have been the end of this challenge. Oh, that was close. That was so close. Okay, so... I think this is the last classroom. I'll double check. I'll take the long way around just so I can make sure. And I gotta make sure I don't run into Senpai's class. Oh, that was close. Okay, nope, not this floor. Not that floor. Okay, good. That is it in there. So I just gotta clean up in here. So all that's left in here is the teacher. Fortunately, we were behind Senpai, which is why he didn't notice us. Oh, that was a close one. We almost got caught. Well, I almost got caught. Yandere-chan and I almost got caught. Okay, so this is almost it. Just one more teacher. And then I could go dump the rest of these bodies in the incinerator. And then clean up all of the blood. And I almost went into Senpai's classroom again! As you can see, we got this nice pile of bodies over here. They are looking like they're having a blast over there. Fortunately, if they glitch through the wall, I can still get to them because they will be in the bathroom there. I noticed that once before. I was grabbing a teacher that I had hid in the bathroom, and I saw an arm coming through the wall, and I was like, what is that? What even is that? Where is that arm coming from? And then I realized, oh, bathroom's on the other side of this wall. It was just one of the many corpses that I dumped off the roof. Really like this teacher's hairstyle. I don't know if you can see it, but kind of reminds me of, like, it's not exactly the same, but the way it's got the three little bumps kind of reminds me of Aquata from The Little Mermaid. She's Ariel's oldest sister. And she's got the three little bumps on her veins. So I said before that I wasn't making any footprints, but it seems like I am making a couple footprints right here at the incinerator. So that's going to be fun to clean up. Sometimes the game does glitch like that, like you won't be making any footprints, and then all of a sudden you do, and then it's like, what? Where did that come from? That is definitely a lot of footprints. Now, the thing that I find really annoying, though, is that, like, you have to wait until the incinerator is completely done before the cops can't find them. So, like, when I messed up the last time and I accidentally went to class, it wasn't the blood that the teacher found, it was a corpse that they found. And the police were able to find every single body in the school, even though they'd been in the incinerator for half an hour already. It's like, what? Why? It's like, how? I mean, sure, they can always turn the incinerator off, I guess, and open it up, but all those bodies are going to be charcoal, and yeah. And why would you even look inside of the incinerator at the end of the day? I mean, what, do you just need to see if it needs to be run? Or something, and that's how they found the bodies? But if it's already running, then you just be like, oh, okay, well, it's already running, so, yeah, it's obviously taking care of everything. So, like, I can understand if, like, you leave the bodies in there, and nobody finds them, somebody does find him because he didn't activate the incinerator. That I can understand, because it's like, oh yeah, I should check to see if there's anything in the incinerator. Yes, there is, and oh my gosh. Or you could be like, oh yeah, I need to dump some trash in here, and oh my gosh. Holy crap, what are all these dead bodies doing in this incinerator? Silly Yandere-chan. The incinerator is not for bodies, it's for trash. Although, I guess this one counts. Midori, Galina! You're trash. Trash! Trash! What, she's still gonna be, like, emailing Yandere Dev from hell? Silly Midori. Oops. I accidentally picked up the garbage. Sensei, you're the last one. Or at least I hope you are. I'm gonna check the bathroom just in case there's someone else in there. And oh gosh, I really hope. Okay, yeah, we still got another hour left of lunch, or of class. I was like, oh gosh, I just realized it's still almost 12 o'clock. It's like, oh wait, lunch doesn't start until 1. So yeah. Whew. So we still got some time before the delinquents show up and before Senpai starts wandering around school. Hopefully none of the bodies got clipped into the bathroom over here. If they did, then we can take care of them, but if not, okay, good. There's nobody's in bathroom here, so we are good to go take a shower and clean my bloody ass, and then we're gonna go mop up all of this blood. And the reason I want to take a shower is because it will take us a while to clean up the blood and class is going to start, and I really don't want to take the chance of Senpai seeing me while I'm covered in blood and of course insane. So we're going to take a shower and we're going to laugh off all of our insanity, and then we're going to start cleaning up all of the blood. And ah, Yan-chan, you naked girl, dirty girl, but it's okay. Go ahead and put on the team uniform now, and I'm going to carry this over here to the incinerator, and then all we got to do is drop the scissors in the incinerator, and then we can activate that, and then we will be good to go. So grab the scissors, dump that, and activate that bitch. And I'm just gonna laugh over here. There we go. Now we just got to go get ourselves a mop and a bucket and clean up all of this blood. Unfortunately, we can sleep through walls too. So we're gonna get all of this. Oh yeah. Cause that's where most of the blood is at, is right there. But whoa, okay, that bucket went flying. Come on, dip. Dip. There we go. Oh, come on. There we go. And I'm just gonna go ahead and refill this bucket while I'm over here. And I'm going to dump this bucket right here, because this is where we're gonna have to use it. So we'll go grab our mop. And now we can start sweeping up all of this blood. That's some yummy looking blood there. Oh, come on. Sorry, my controller is really glitchy lately. I think it might have been gotten damaged. I need a new one, which sucks because it makes it really hard to do this stuff. And I definitely want to get a new controller before October, because October is when Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 comes out, and I want to do a playthrough of that. I should really do a playthrough of Dragon Ball Xenoverse 1. For those of you who didn't see me talk about it in a previous video, I've got an OC for Dragon Ball Xenoverse, and I really like her story and everything that I've come up with, and I really want to share it with you guys. But I figure it's probably best to do that while playing Dragon Ball Xenoverse. But I want to get that out before Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 comes out, so that way we can play as hopefully the same main character, the same OC that I created before. But I really want to get that video out before that comes out. And if there's any other videos that you guys want to see me make on this channel, let me know in the comments below. There are a couple of other games that I've started and just never really finished uploading them. Like, I had a playthrough of Pokemon X that I started a long time ago, and when the game first came out, and I still haven't finished editing it. I've finished recording all of it, but I just need to edit all those videos and upload them. But at this point, it's like, well, it's been like 2 years, and I don't know if anyone even cares about it anymore. So, like, if you guys have seen those videos and you want me to finish uploading them, I will. But if nobody comments about that, then I probably won't. I am getting one of those recordable kits for my 3DS, so that I can start to getting much better gameplay footage of those games, because I want to do a playthrough of Pokemon Sun. I want to do a regular playthrough, and I also want to do a playthrough, and I'm full. I want to do a playthrough where I want to do a playthrough where I play regularly, and I also want to do a playthrough where I use only the feline Pokemon. I think that would be a fun little challenge that nobody's really done before. Plus, those of you who have seen my top 10 video of my favorite Pokemon know that I love cats. If you've seen my other videos, you know that I have a cat named Leo, and he is my baby, and I just love, nope, not supposed to, close that, open! I love kitties, and I was really excited to see Litten, because he's a kitty, and I think it would be really cool to just play through the whole game with only cat Pokemon. But let me know what you guys think. Should I finish the X and Y, or the playthrough of Pokemon X first? Should I continue playing Card of Sakura, Card Friends? That's another one. Like, I've only gotten one video out, and I'd have to double check, but I don't think it's even gotten any comments. Like, the views were, like, pretty small. And I know that there is a fan base out there, and as you can see, I even have a Cardcaptor Sakura costume now that I can wear for the videos. but I don't want to really... It's an okay game, but because it's in Japanese, it's really hard to play, and I can't really read kanji, and of course, Google Translate doesn't work very good either, and we're finally full, so let's go ahead and dump this, but, yeah, that's... Sorry, distracted by game. But I don't know if I should continue playing that or not. If enough people ask me to, then I probably will. But otherwise, I might just play something else. I'm going to go ahead and leave this up on another floor here. So that I can use it up there. I don't know if I can fill it at another floor. But I'll have to... I guess we could always check and find out. Did I get all the blood in here? Yes, and in here. Good. If there's any other games that you guys want to see me play, leave a comment about that too. If you want to see me play more Yandere Sim, I am very much open to it. But at the same time, only if people want, and I will be giving the same warnings at the beginning of the game at the beginning of the video that I did this one, because there are a lot of, like I said, there are a lot of younger people watching my videos, and now it's time for lunch. So Senpai is going to be coming downstairs soon. Fortunately, we're all clean, so even if he does see me, he won't be like, "Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, what are you doing? Get away from me! No, wait!" And then I get the game over screen. So, yeah. Fortunately, nothing suspicious about mopping up the blood. Nope. I'm just a blue janitor. I'm getting my janitor on. Getting my, it's my class duty today. I was signed up in class to clean the school today, to mop the floors, and this, I am tempted to just let this classroom be, because I don't want to accidentally go to class. Okay. Okay, good. I managed to get the blood by my desk. Do not want to accidentally go to class. Alright, my classroom is clean. And we've missed Senpai, so that's good. Get this. And get this over here. Okay. And this mop is probably full. Well, no, it's not full, because it is giving me the sweeping option, but we're still going to go ahead and dip this, because if you let it get full twice, then that's all you're going to be able to mop up. But if you dip it before it's completely full, then you can dip it one more time and get an extra use out of that water. So, nice little trick for you guys. Because this is a very tedious task. Actually, I want to come into the bathroom. Okay, so there are sinks in the other bathrooms. There are utility sinks in here, so you probably can fill the bucket up in one of these other bathrooms. I should try that. I want to try that and see. Oh, this is a lot of blood, but we're almost done. We're almost done. Gonna clean up Senpai's classroom next. Go clean up Senpai's classroom and sulk around his desk a little bit. Because it's Senpai's desk and he sits here all day long. Wish he would sit on me like that. That got a little creepy. But we are playing a creepy character right now. Yandere-chan is definitely creepy. She's a stalker! She's a murderer! She's a yandere girl. She's a bully. She's a murderer. She's a janitor. She's all these things. She's got all these skill sets. Why wouldn't Senpai love us? I mean, we've got all these skill sets. We're so talented. He should really love us. He should totally date us and marry us. And let us have his babies. We're going to have 17 babies. We need to have a lot of babies because we gotta clean up. Or we gotta... Oh, I forgot about these two! Oh, I forgot that these two were in here! Oh, I completely forgot that these two were even in here. I can't get them yet because Senpai's down there and I don't want him to see me. Okay. Mop is full. It's like my goal is to get... Oh, you know what? I suppose I could just take them up to the roof and dump them off the roof. He won't see that. Actually, we'll just take this up to the roof because there's a bucket up there. Still gotta clean up all this up here, too. Oh yeah, we got a whole other bucket. A whole other mop, too. Probably should have closed the door on Pippi and Ryoto, but I think they'll be okay. I don't think Senpai goes that way. Okay. Class is going again, so yep, we're good. We are good. Well, now that I think about it, even if I had taken them to the incinerator right now, the delinquents would have been there and I wouldn't have been able to get away with it, so yeah. Because they would have attacked me. They would not care. So we gotta close. Just, I don't think we'll be passing by here, but no, yeah, I think we do have to pass by there. Oh wait, no we don't, because we got stairs over here. Okay, try not to step in this blood, because now that we've cleaned up all that other blood, I've got a feeling footprints are gonna appear, and I don't want that to happen. So gotta go find the stairs. And, oh, I went the wrong way. Too bad I can't dump them over this railing. It's only the short railing that you can dump them off of. So, bye-bye, Pippi. I think there's still blood down there anyway. Yeah, there's still blood down there, so we're good. Too bad you can't dump the mop off there. Of course, you gotta go down there anyway, but still. Okay. It's like, wait, where am I going? Oh, yeah. Oh, school looks so clean now. It's so clean. Okay, unfortunately, it should be an hour now, so we should be able to dump these guys in the incinerator. So that will be good. Yeah, I went the right way this time. Okay, go ahead and dump him down there. And now we just, I'll go ahead and grab this mop and dip it. Come on, there we go. Just so that we can have an extra mop. In fact, I'm just gonna go ahead and drop this off down there. So that, there's actually some footprints over here that we missed. So, there we go. Go ahead and drop this off over here. Actually, sweep this up. Come on. Don't step in the blood. Thank you. Okay. There we go. Now I just gotta grab the little lovebirds. And dang! You see the way they were positioned? Oh, talk about your lovebirds. But yeah, these two actually do have crushes on each other, but they haven't told each other how they feel yet, which kind of makes me feel a little bit bad about killing them. Because there's a lot of characters out there that from shows that I really enjoy, and I care about the characters, and they've got they're in those similar kinds of situations. I mean, we got OCs like that who like each other, but are too afraid to tell each other. Oh, one of them's more afraid than the other, but I won't get too far into that. If you guys are watching in the future and Journey of the Heart is actually out at the time, then you'll know. Or if you've been following me a long time, then you'd know who they are. But yeah, and that was quick. That was really quick. So I'm gonna go ahead up here and I'm going to find the bucket. Where did I leave the bucket? There it is. Okay, and I'll just leave that there because I gotta go up here now and because I left the other mop over here. And it's too bad you can't carry two mops at once. That would be really nice if you could carry them both at once. Or like carry the mop and the bucket at the same time. That would be nice. Okay. So now we got that done. And we're gonna go back this way so that we can get to the bucket. Okay, and come on, let me dip, there we go. And now the water's too bloody, but that's okay. So we're going to come back down here and mop up the rest of this blood. And then we will be good for the day. And unfortunately, because my waifu did get to dropped off the map, somebody will find her because she did not get incinerated. So even if we do try to get away with murder, like even if we clean up all this rest of the stuff, they're still gonna find her. But I still want to do all this anyway, just because, you know, you're gonna have to do this in the actual game, and hopefully in the actual game they won't be able to fall off the map. So yeah. It would be nice if Yandere Dev could make it so that you don't have to worry about that. But unfortunately... wait, what? Who is that? Oh, that's the guidance counselor! Okay, I was like, what? Who did I miss? But it's the guidance counselor. Why am I still running like I'm in Yandere Vision? There we go. Nope, and I'm still running slow. I'm still running like I'm in Yandere Vision. Oh, I found a glitch. Oh, I found a new glitch. Fortunately, we managed to fix everything up. So, oh man. But yeah, there's the nurse. Unfortunately, we can't do anything to her yet. Like, you can't even talk to her. You can't even interact with these. These aren't even object blocks yet. They're just objects. It's kind of spooky when you think about it. So yeah, this is where I thought I'd seen them, but it's actually in here. This is who I saw. And yes, you can interact with her, but,
What can I help you with? Don't misbehave.
Yep, way to tell the girl who's standing in your office during class time not to misbehave. It's like, she's either here because she's misbehaving, or she was sent here because she was misbehaving. It's like, her being here is misbehavior enough, unless she was sent here, in which case, she was sent here because she was misbehaving. So, it should be all of the blood. Oh, this is so annoying. Oh, I almost forgot to activate the incinerator. There we go. Oh, I was really hoping that would fix this running glitch. Ah, this latest build was so glitchy. Like, there are a lot of glitches that I've seen in this latest build. Even though Yandere Dev has released a lot of bug fixing builds for this. Well, not really a lot, but enough. And, but even so, there's still a lot of glitches. Like, if you, you attack a teacher, you can get stuck there. If you, do stuff with the turtle, it can, mess with your, commands. Like, I tried doing some things with the turtle. Like, I tried teleporting to the turtle, and suddenly I couldn't interact with doors or talk to people, which was really annoying. But, yeah, the turtle is new. That is new to this latest build. I need to check the bathrooms too. Okay. But it makes sense that there's going to be a lot of glitches that need to be worked out. A lot of bugs. This is a bug testing build. This is not actually a working game, and there is some blood in here. And there's a footprint there, too. So we got to go clean that up. There's a mop. There should be a mop up here. Yes. Okay. So, this game is not actually even a game yet. It's just for bug testing. But even still, it's still pretty fun. It's a lot of stuff to do in it, and there's always more to do in it than there was before. And how did I get a footprint over here? Like, seriously. I wonder if you can pick that up. Is it just like a decoration or an Easter egg, or nope? Doesn't even make sense. Why is it sitting on the floor? It should be sitting on the wall. It's like, normally fire extinguishers are up on the wall, not on the floor. So, yeah, that's kind of weird. I didn't hide anything in here, did I? I didn't think so. And I got the blood in here already? Yep. Okay. So, check all the other bathrooms. Because I want to be absolutely sure that I got everything. I think this is the one where the teacher saw me. Or where the student saw me killing the teacher, and I had to... I just left her in the classroom. Got this one. And technically I can't even try to go home or go to class yet, because with that incinerator running, they'll be able to find the bodies. And with my waifu glitched off the map, can't do anything. There should not be any blood over there, in there, because that's Senpai's classroom. I didn't kill anyone in his classroom. So, yeah, we're all good now. So, yeah, we're good. Now that there's new teachers in here to catch us. Senpai! He doesn't even notice. Will he notice if I go in front of him? I'm curious. Yep, he notices. And there's Kokona's seat. You can tell it's Kokona's because it's got a bag sitting next to it. One of these days, Yandere Dev's going to make it so that she starts carrying her bag with her everywhere. I just noticed this, actually. There's a sticker on the back of all the chairs. That's kind of cool. Nice little detail. There's a lot of nice little details in this game. But, okay, let's go see if the incinerator is done. Because we got all the blood. We're good. Oh, actually, I do want to test that out. Let's see if this works on any sink or just the one. And I think we're running better again. Yay, we're running faster again. Yay! The glitch fixed itself. I didn't even notice that. I wonder if you could do this in the boys' room, though. Nope, can't do it in the boys' bathroom. Probably because we're not supposed to be in there. Wonder if we can watch Senpai use the toilet. That seems so gross. It's like, you could drown Kokona in the toilet. Or you can dump her with water. So you can electrocute her. You do a lot of stuff in the bathroom. But anyway, let's just go this way faster. Let's go check on the incinerator. See if it's good. And we still got another half hour left. Well, that should still be it. As far as I know, they don't notice the bloody mops or bloody mop water. You'd think that they would, though, but I don't think that they do. So, we're gonna go ahead and... I can't pass time, can I? Nope. Because my wife is still out there. Somewhere. I have no idea where she is. So, let's go ahead and end the day. And we're going to go ahead and go on home. Teacher discovers a corpse. They survived the school. What?! What?! What the? But we burned all their bodies! They should not be able to find all those bodies! Glitch? Yeah, that's not right. I mean, nobody's gonna notice me anyway, because they couldn't find any murder weapons. They can't link Yandere-chan. Do not have enough evidence to perform an arrest. Okay, but it says that they're missing, not dead. What? So confused. But you guys saw that I completed the challenge, except for my waifu, because she glitched through the stairs, so there was nothing I could do about that. But I finished this challenge. So, thank you guys for watching. If you want to see more of Yandere Simulator, see me test out other bugs, or anything else, let me know in the comments down below. If you want to see me playing any other games, again, let me know, and I will see you guys later.